Hey guys, what's up? So it is raining here. It started raining yesterday and it is still raining today. And I wanted to do a 90 Days of Loving Me video update. I honestly can't remember when I started the journey. I could go back and look at the video and do the date and everything. But shortly after starting the journey, I made a commitment to myself that my journey was going to be longer than 90 days. And honestly, shortly thereafter, I just stopped keeping track of where I was in the 90 days. So for me, it's really not that important that I go back and decide where I am, figure out where I am on the 90 days. I could be nearing the end of the 90 days. I could be somewhere in the middle. I could be past the 90 days. I don't know. What's important to me is that I don't care. And what also is important to me is that what I've learned on the journey so far. And I said shortly into the journey, I made a commitment to myself that my journey was going to be a lifetime journey. It is going to be something that I'm going to continue to do beyond the 90 days. And I'm sure many of my good friends that are on the journey with me feel the same way. At least I hope you guys do. When I first saw the video from my friend Jackie Black Lacker, I said to myself, well, I love myself, yada 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 yada, went through all the motions, and shortly thereafter I made my first video. And before I made the video, I said to myself, I was just like, you know what, you really don't take time out for yourself, you really don't do things for you take time out and you have rest periods, and it's basically just to recharge yourself and go back to doing whatever you have on the schedule for my organization, and that is totally true. So what I decided was, you know what, I'm gonna do this. And I'm going to make a point to take time out for me and do things for me. And along the way, I've rediscovered arts. I've rediscovered laughter. And you can look at my videos and see that laughter has been a part of my life. And anybody that knows me knows that laughter has been a part of my life. But there has been a period in my life where laughter was just like a mask that I put on to hide all the pain and stuff that I was going through. It was basically there, a smile, laughter, to make other people feel good, to make other people feel comfortable. And along this journey, I rediscovered that at the end of the day, I need to take care of me. I need to look out for me. My smile and my laughter needs to be for me. And so I want to say thank you to Jackie for, one, introducing me to this journey, and two, really helping me rediscover me and fall in love with me all over again. After 29 months of homelessness and a system that is so badly broken, you're told that there has to be something wrong with you. That's the reason you're homeless. You made a mistake somewhere. You've screwed up. You've done something wrong. And no matter how strong you are, sooner or later, it starts to chip away at your confidence, at your faith in yourself. No matter how strong you are, it just chips away at it. So along the way on the journey, I just started rediscovering me and falling in love with me. And it's been an amazing experience. And time that I take out is more now than just a time to recharge and get my energy in order for me to go out and do another outreach or plan another event. Now it's like I'm taking time out because I genuinely want to spend time with me. I genuinely want to spend time with friends. I genuinely want to hang out and explore. So it's been an awesome journey for me, and I'm gonna keep the journey going. And today I'm adding something new to my journey. As many of you know, I have this thing called Restoring the Temple, Mind, Body, and Soul. And I am the first to admit that I have not been committed to getting to the gym. I've had good intentions and I've wanted to get to the gym, but I don't get there all the time. Things come up, life gets in the way, and I don't make it. I had injury and things like that. So today I woke up and I said to myself, it is a week before my 41st birthday, and I remember where I was this time last year, and I remember what was going through my mind a week before my 41st birthday. I remember a lot of what was going through my mind. I remember speaking with friends and stuff like that. I just remember so much. And so when I woke up this morning, I woke up and I said to myself, today is the day that I am going to be fully committed to taking care of myself emotionally, physically, and spiritually. And it's gonna be more than just taking time out to go do some photography. It's gonna be more than just taking time out to go and be with friends. It's gonna be more than just taking time out to have a bubble bath, to make myself a grilled cheese sandwich. It's going to be more than that. It's going to be me changing my life. And when I say changing my life, I mean changing what goes into my temple. What goes into my temple food-wise, what goes into my temple with what I read, with what I watch, with who I hang out with. And as I start to make this transition from 40 into 41, I'm realizing that there are things in my life that I need to remove. Bad eating habits, poor fitness habits. And thankfully, and by the grace of God, my body is handling itself with HIV. I've never been recommended to start any HIV drugs. Nothing. And thankfully, my body is doing awesome against HIV, given all the other things that I'm dealing with. And I definitely have reduced the stress in my life. Having my own apartment really removed a lot of stress. It really took away a lot of things that were stressing me out. Stressed about where am I going to eat. Stressed about am I going to be able to get in to see my doctor. Just all the stress that was there from being homeless has been reduced. I won't say it's gone away. It is definitely reduced. So today I'm saying to myself, you know what, I'm gonna make a more conscious effort and a bigger commitment to making sure my body stays healthy and doing everything I can to make sure my immune system stays healthy. And that includes getting to the gym and eating right. So what I've done starting today is keeping track of what I'm eating. Not really counting calories or anything like that. I'm just keeping track of what I'm eating, and I'm making better choices. And my choices have to be based on what my income is. And my income is little to nothing. So my choices have to center around that. That's it. I'm just, my journey of the 90 days of loving myself is going to be a lifelong journey. So I'm gonna continue to do the update videos. I'm gonna continue to keep trying to live my best life, and I'm gonna continue to fall in love with me, Lewis, all over again, and love who I am and love where my life is. That's going to be my commitment, and my commitment is to stay healthy and keep my body healthy by identifying and doing things that work for me. Peace and blessings, guys. Bye-bye.